Hey, it's Professor Dave. Let's talk about ideal gases.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
Let's recall our definition of a gas as the phase of matter where atoms of a substance are in motion and fill their container. If we make a couple simplifying assumptions about gases, we can make some easy predictions. Those are that, one, particles of a gas are dimensionless points in random motion, and the identity of the gas is irrelevant. Could be anything. And two, that the particles don't interact apart from elastic collisions, bouncing off one another like balls on a pool table. These things aren't completely true, but they make the math easy and surprisingly accurate. So these kinds of samples are called ideal gases. When examining an ideal gas, we want to be able to discuss four variables. One, pressure. This is the force the gas is exerting on its container, or rather, how much the particles are hitting the sides. Two, temperature. This is the amount of heat energy available to be transferred into kinetic energy of motion. The higher the temperature, the faster the particles move. Three, volume. How big is the container? And four, moles. How many particles are there in the container? So, how many particles, how big is the container, how fast are the particles moving, and how often do they hit the sides? As it turns out, these variables depend on one another in interesting ways that have been formulated into laws. Let's look at a piston. While keeping the moles and temperature the same, in other words, the same number of particles moving at the same speed, if we compress the volume, the pressure must go up. The particles will be hitting the sides more often because there is less distance to travel to hit a side. That means that pressure and volume are inversely proportional. If one goes down, the other goes up. This is expressed in Boyle's Law, P1 V1 equals P2 V2. If we double one variable, we have to cut the other one in half in order to keep this equation valid. Volume and temperature are also related. If we have gas in a balloon and we heat it up, the particles will move more quickly. In order to keep pressure constant, or hit the sides with the same frequency, the volume will have to expand. This means that volume and temperature are directly proportional. If one doubles, the other must double. This is expressed in Charles' Law. When we do calculations with temperature, we must always use an absolute temperature scale called the Kelvin scale. 1 degree Kelvin is the same magnitude as 1 degree Celsius, but 0 Kelvin is absolute zero, the lowest temperature possible, a complete absence of heat energy. This helps us avoid weird mathematical issues that would arise if we were doing a calculation involving a negative or zero temperature. To get Kelvin from Celsius, just add 273. To go the other way, subtract. The combined gas law is like a combination of Boyle's and Charles'. Avogadro's law says that equal volumes of gases at the same temperature and pressure contain the same number of molecules. Specifically, that 1 mole of ideal gas occupies 22.4 liters at standard temperature and pressure, regardless of the identity of the gas. Lastly, all the variables correlate in one equation called the ideal gas law. This also contains the gas constant R, which makes these calculations intelligible in our man-made units. There are a number of values for R depending on the units, but we will predominantly use this one. This equation is useful when we aren't looking at a change, but just to know the values of all four variables at once, like in this case. We could know the pressure, temperature, and volume of a gas, and quickly calculate how many moles of particles must be in the sample. So if you are looking at a sample of gas, and you have three of the four variables, you can solve for the fourth using the ideal gas law. If you are given some initial conditions, as well as some final conditions, you can use one of the other laws to find the other information. Just plug in what you know, and solve for what you don't. Let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials, and as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.